Wish you could turn back time to the good old days when a mama set us to sleep on our stressed out. Comment down below if you know the song. Hello guys, welcome back to Try and Fitness. Hope you're having a beautiful day. Today we'll be discussing something pretty important, pretty dope, pretty nice. It's plateau. Alright, so it's not nice in the sense of being nice. The fact that a lot of questions have come to me about plateau. I've plateaued in this, how do I break through it? So I decided I'll make a video about it. For the purpose of organization, first we'll be going through number one, what is plateau? Two, why does it occur? And number three, how do you break through a plateau? What is plateau? Plateau just means hitting a rock, pretty much, in your training. So you've been losing weight, and then all of a sudden, you hit a rock, you can't go any further. Or you've been gaining weight, then voila, you can gain weight any further. Or you've been lifting heavy weight, you know, progressive overload, and then all of a sudden, you can't lift any heavier like that. So why does this happen? Number one, the common culprit in the room, ignorance. Your training is whack, something is wrong in your training, you gotta fix it. It could be in your diet, training plan, or it could just be the fact that you're impatient. Either way, it's some sort of ignorance. Number two, negligence. So a lot of people are negligent to the fact that it's a long process, and they, for example, leave the little things out. For example, saying, oh, I want to do weight training, I'm just gonna focus on cardio, or I'm gonna do 15 hours of cardio in a week, or I'll lose more weight, or something like that. It's not the fact that they don't know, it's the fact that they just want to do prioritize one part of training over the other, which is not the case. You shouldn't neglect any part of your training, but resistance and otherwise. Now, of course, they've got babies on that, and we'll discuss them. So how do you break through a plateau, you ask me? You gotta fix the aforementioned. If you have a problem with your diet, you gotta find it. Usually the main problem in the diet is calories. Calories in, calories out. You can't break that rule of thermodynamics. You gotta fix that. You gotta make sure you're counting your calories with. So how do you do that? Get a weighing scale. You can't assume what which one is over the other, or this is like 50 grams, is like 20 grams. No, you gotta know for sure. So get a weighing scale and understand how many calories. Understand how to track your calories, how to track your macros. I'm gonna make a video very soon on how to weigh food, so people will really understand how to weigh food. But you can check my other videos. I've weighed food in the past, you see what I do with that. And most importantly, most foods are supposed to be tracked when cooked. So understanding which of your foods you're tracking before cooking or after cooking is a very important thing to do. For example, when you see the packet of rice and it says 100 grams of this, on the packet it shows 100 grams of the rice uncooked. Now when you're putting it in the app, you gotta understand that 100 grams of rice uncooked gets more. You definitely need to track the cooked one in the app. You understand that? So you have to understand very little differences about that, because such inconsistencies could cause a problem in your diet. Another way to get through a plateau is carb cycling. What does carb cycling mean? Normally, a lot of people just, when they want to be in a deficit, your culprit is the carbs. They drop the carbs, they increase the protein and the fat just a little as well, right? So the point is, if you're on the same level of carbs for like 2 weeks, there'll be a point where your body gets used to it and say, okay, since we're only going to be eating 50 grams of carb, you've dropped it too low, and then your body reaches a plateau because it has just been desensitized so much it's no longer sensitive to the dropping of your carbs. What do you do? From Monday to Friday, let's say you're deciding to drop your carbs by 20 grams per day. So Monday was 200 grams, you dropped it by 10 grams till Friday. So that's 5 days. You probably dropped your carbs by 100 by now. So you're at 100 grams on Friday. Now, you don't want to just keep dropping and dropping and dropping and dropping. Let's finally you decide, okay, I'm gonna stop at 50 grams, that's my least. You don't stay at 50 for so long. You stay there for maybe 2-3 days, then you mix it up. You go to 70, you go to 80, drop down to 50. You gotta mix up the numbers. You can't just leave your carb as your carbs at one point, because at that point your body just gets used to it. Doesn't mean you should just flare it up high and get a load. No, I'm just saying the subtle differences, that's what you call carb cycling. It helps your system, you know, keep guessing like that. The same thing, almost the same logic applies to other types of plateauing, weight gain or in PRs as well. But we'll talk about that in another video. Alright, so basically this is a rundown overview. As you know, right here, fitness in a nutshell, we're not trying to make things too complicated, you understand? We're just trying to make it fun, easy to understand, and yeah. So if you love the video, leave a like, subscribe, it helps me out a ton, and you know, let's get those gains, guys. And stay safe in this quarantine period, and be healthy. Love you guys. Peace. See you.
I've lost everything, but I always bounce back. Thank God for Monado, always kept me on track. Wanted anything, really wanna go back. Back before the leaf, it cut my family off.